Oh, this is what I, oh, okay. After I just yelled like 20 minutes of misogyny against women, my beautiful wedding was beautiful. And this is what I forgot to say. It's like, I had an awesome wedding because my wife planned it. And she's fucking rad and she did a good job. And it was a completely traditional, normal fucking wedding. Because all my friends are like hipsters that live in Silver Lake, and they're all comedians, and they're all ironic, and they're all idiots like me that have like animals and shit and Care Bears and all their clothing. And all my friends are like, dude, you're getting married? That is fucking awesome, because they're thinking it's gonna be the best free booze party ever for them. They're like, dude, there's this fucking dope ass bowling alley in Eagle Rock. You should totally get fucking married there, bro. We put a bouncy castle in the parking lot. We'll fucking, dude, we'll ride up my friend like rebuild Vespas and their hybrids. We'll all ride up on Vespas playing the same song in our iPod so it's like unison. It'll be fucking dope, man. I got a friend who's got like an Optimus Prime costume. He can get ordained as a Jedi and he can fucking marry you guys and we'll all have wine coolers. How fucking dope would that be? And that's fine for like a Halloween party or like a house, but that's like your fucking, I want one unironic thing in my life. One day where it was just me in a tuxedo, in a fucking church, in a fucking limousine, and then we drive off, sea in hell, we're going to Puerto Rico. That's all I wanted. That is all I wanted. My wife provided that for me, and it was awesome because we got married in a church, and I'm not particularly religious. I'm not mad at religion. When I was like 19, I was an atheist. I was like, I don't believe in God. Fuck you, God. You fucking dick. I read Ayn Rand, and I love the skateboard. Like, which is such a, you're 19, but it's such a retarded way to go off, go around. And then I got older in like my late 20s, I turned 30. It's like, I realized I'm not really an atheist. I'm agnostic, all right? I'm agnostic. Like, there's probably something, I don't know what it is. Jesus sounds really fucking cool. I love the shit out of Star Wars. So why can't there be both? Why can't I, hang out with the angels and get a lightsaber someday? Crossing my fingers, saying my prayers, talking to Yoda. So agnostic is so much better to say because it saves you so many arguments that I don't have time for anymore to argue with some asshole in line at Starbucks or for coffee. Like, oh, what the fuck, dude? You believe in God, man? You fucking dick. I'm like, no, I'm agnostic. And they have to Google that and look it up while I'm driving away. Putting them in my rearview mirror like an Eddie Vedder lyric, really, if you think about it. But yeah, it's just like, you don't fucking know. Even if you know, you don't fucking know. So it's like, it's fine. But my wife, she's Lutheran, which is, I don't know, if you're not religious and you're looking to get into like some form of Christianity, Lutheran is the best fucking one. Lutheran is Christianity light. It's all the awesomeness of Christianity, none of the calories or hatred or Fox News bullshit. It's fucking... It's super dope. Like, no, it is, dude. It's so good. Like, yeah, I've gone to church. It's like 35 minutes. You kneel a couple times, not too much. It's easy on the knees. You sing like one song, you can lip sync. They don't give a shit, right? And then it's like fist bump, peace be with you, see you next Easter, Audi 5K. It's so good. It's like, it's the perfect, if I was gonna be religious, I'd totally be Lutheran. And here's the thing, because when you got married in a church, I didn't know, I always thought, I heard this, but I never believed it. When you get married in a church or any religious building, you have to meet with the priest or the pastor 3 times in like a pre-wedding, like marriage counseling session, like make sure you don't beat her and all this shit, all old hat stuff. And so it was, like one girl laughed, I was like, you don't beat her, do you? I'm so much bigger than her. If I were to hit her, you would know, she'd be in heaven. I just yell a lot. I love her so much. She's in the room. Everybody, please stop. No, but this is the thing. So we meet with her pastor, and like I was like, oh, shit, I don't want to do it. But then I found out her church is really cool. They do like gay and lesbian weddings are totally open to like the transgender, GBLT thing. Like, and that, because like a church thing, like God doesn't care where you put your boner, like, so I don't, the fuck do I care? Like, that's everybody. If you want to get married and fucking spin the wheel, you go ahead. Everybody should be able to get married. So we go, and we meet with the guy, and my wife, before we go in, he's like, listen, this is my pastor, this is my church, you're funny, ha-ha, blah, 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 action figures, boners, all that kind of shit. For the next hour, I need you to tuck your crazy in, okay? You're gonna tuck your crazy in, and there's gonna be no F-bombs or S-bombs, and none of this finger gesture that you're so, if you're telling a story, you can't hump any furniture because you think it's funny, all right? No, don't tell them you play like 8 hours of Lego Star Wars a day on the Xbox, and you have theory, like, just don't, if you keep it crazy tucked in, I will buy you Pinkberry right after. And Pinkberry's like, get a fancy frozen yogurt. It's like, and when I go, it's like an $8 thing because I get a large and as much fucking fruit as they can cram in. And you know that little, like that little yogurt boner that pokes up? They always try and put the lid on it. And I'm like, no, no, it's the best part. And I just lick the yogurt boner right in the store. Just look at my face. Oh, it's like baby angels peeing in your hair. It feels so good. Couldn't be wrong. Couldn't be wrong. So we, oh, pink day. My little angel boners. So we go, and this is the thing. I'm like, oh, this guy's gonna be a dick and this and that. We go, and the guy is like the coolest freaking dude ever. He's like in his 50s. He surfs. He plays video games. Like I said, he does gay and lesbian weddings. Like he's rocking. He's wearing, and it's hot at summertime. He's wearing pink Argyle sweater, long sleeve, matching pink socks. No weird vibe whatsoever. Just a man, and you know, no creepy. Like, does this guy take kids in an ice cream truck? Just a nice dude who loves Jesus and surfing. So he's walking on water like Jesus with a mean cutback, who is awesome. And he's totally. And we're getting along, and like, oh man, we're drinking coffee bean. And I love it so much. And, oh, I love you, priest man and pastor. Why won't you be my dad? You know, you ever meet like an old man? Like, why can't you adopt me? Like when I used to go like the Cosby Show growing up, but I used to tell my parents, those are my real parents. They're gonna come get me someday. I don't know what this shit is. They must have been a mix-up because I fucking the you know Mr. Huxtable. So we go through the thing. We go through the thing, and it's like an hour, and he sets like a little clock, and like there's like 5 minutes left in the clock, and we're goofing around and joking. We're not even talking about marriage stuff. There's like a part in the packet about sex. Like, what makes you most uncomfortable about sex? I'm like talking with a priest about it. How about that? So what is reverse cowboy? Does she have to fit? You know, like, I don't want to have that talk with a man of the cloth. So we get through it, and it's like 5 minutes left, and I'm thinking, oh, fucking Pinkberry, gonna be so awesome. And we get through it, and then the guy's like, oh, I see the time. You know what, guys? Okay, we've had a lot of fun today, but I really don't think I'd be doing my due diligence if I just didn't take it down for just 1 minute and get serious with you two, okay? I want you guys, you know, get serious for a minute. Dan, man, I want you guys to take each other's hands, and I want you guys to look each other in the eye, and I want you to think about the fact that one day, one of you will probably have to close the coffin on the other person. Right? Right? We're having coffee bean and talking about surfing Hermosa Beach, and 10 seconds later, life is nowhere but a journey to the grave, and you go there alone after you put your loved one on the ground, or rotten and maggots eat the flesh. What the fuck? I'm dropping F-bombs like Hiroshima and Dresden combined at this point, but I want that pink bear and I want to fucking win, right? So I keep it all tucked in, I compose myself, and I'm like, you know what, Pastor John? You are absolutely 100% correct. If I were to ever lose her, if she were to ever die, that would be the saddest day of my life. And there would be a hole in my heart that I could never fill again. But that's not like the worst thing that could happen if we got married. What about freak jet ski accident on the honeymoon doesn't kill her, does render her completely C4 murder ball quadriplegic. Because that's how 30 or 40 years, you know, like closing the coffin on one sad day, that's not closing the coffin on one sad day. That is 30 or 40 years of pushing a wheelchair around the Beverly Center. Asking, why do you need new shoes? The ones you have on are so clean. Give me back my life. That's true love. That's what love is. Love isn't like when we're both 20 and 30 and have nice boobs and all this shit. Love is when you're old and you fall apart and you're missing shit and you still love each other. That's fucking true. I had an old man one time come up. I liked your set, but that last part about the wheelchair was very disconcerting. My wife, she had some ailment. She was in a wheelchair for like the last 10 years of her life. And I'm like, did you love her like as much as you did before she was in the wheelchair? And she's like, yeah. I'm like, well, fucking there you go, buddy. You know, like, that's all it is. Like, that's what love is. It's the same thing. Like, I'm not religious. She's Christian. People are always like, what's going to happen when you die? Yeah, she's Christian. You're like, what happens when you die? I'm like, she goes to heaven to play ping pong with the angels, and I go to hell to fight my dad and Hitler. Fuck yeah. Sign me up twice. Don't you dare get sad. Life is a fucking struggle. Yeah. It is, but it's a fun struggle. If everything was great all the time, it'd be miserable. But the fact that we have things that are miserable that we can complain about, awesome. It is. I just want to sop it up and eat it, like start like a McDonald's dipper thing. That's it. They have like those apple dippers. Oh, we're healthy now. Get some apple slices. Oh, no, here's a 14,000 calorie caramel thing for your kid. We're raising a generation of children that will never see their feet. That's all I'm saying. I would love to see some kindergarten macaroni art. None of the characters are all just on their sides. Little rectangles where their cankles should be.